Hey guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rise. We're back here, home base, the Rady Cave. Once again, we have another OEM, another manufacturer doing a virtual unveil. We are here. I'm excited for this 2021 Lexus IS 300 and Lexus IS 350. Now, because of the world situation that we're in, auto shows have been postponed and are on hold. We're still going to bring it to you because the manufacturers are now doing these virtual unveils. So this will be step one. And then, of course, step two, at the next auto show, we will have our hands on these very cars. But what we're talking about with the all-new IS 300 and IS 350 is Lexus is really promising this all-new driving signature. Now, I know you're probably saying, well, signature, are they autographing something? No. What they're talking about is an autographed driving experience. Very linear, very engaging. And what I'm excited about is that this car, you could get rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, and there's many different engine options and a special new dynamic handling package, also known as DHP. But without further ado, let's go ahead. We're going to start with this beautiful promo ad piece that Lexus did. It involves a racetrack and the new IS 350, so it can't be that bad, right? We're going to watch that, and then we're going to dive into the actual footage that Lexus has given us to bring to you and really showcase this new Lexus IS 350 and 300. So without further ado, let's dive in. All right, guys. So wow, very exciting. That test track was actually put together to now develop their new vehicles. This is the first one. Look at that interior. You have the optional, what you're looking at, that optional 10.3-inch infotainment system screen. They actually moved it 3 inches closer to the driver so you don't have to reach while you're behind the wheel. Love the thickness of the steering wheel, the layout. You're gonna get Apple CarPlay, Android Auto. Now, if you don't go 10.3-inch screen, everything isn't lost, you still get an 8-inch touchscreen. So I would go the optional because that 10.3-inch screen looks absolutely beautiful. Love that two-tone interior. And if you're wondering, well, what's that called, Joe? It's called Circuit Red. It's gonna be an optional interior color. Love the two-tone, love that steering wheel. You can see just the perfect thickness on it. It's not flat bottom, but you know what? I think that it's still gonna be a pleasure to do the business with that wheel. Brushed aluminum brake pedal, brushed aluminum throttle. Even the shifter still looks great. And that dash, the way it lights up, the way that it gives you that information makes you feel like you're on that test track. And that's how it was all developed. Now, the great news is that when it comes to, well, what have they changed, Joe? They've taken a lot from the LFA, lessons from the LFA, and brought it into this car. So you're talking about things like new lighter wheel hub bolts that shed 4 pounds rotating mass. We're talking about forged aluminum A-arms, different springs, different dampers, And then, like I was saying, they're gonna stiffen the whole suspension from front to rear, and there's that optional dynamic handling package. When I have driven different Lexus models, the RS, the RC, they brought some of the RC flavor into this. Of course, you're gonna have that Lexus trackpad, but the screen still is a touchscreen, so it's nice to have that flexibility. The different drive modes, of course, Sport, Sport Plus, and I like what they did. Look at the AC controls. They've changed that all up. That was a sore spot. I know a lot of you watching my other Lexus reviews, especially with the RC cars, you weren't digging that where the AC is located. But I really like the way they did the AC controls, the way the red leather comes down. Start-stop button is in a very, very nice laid out placement. This is an F Sport, of course, because you could see right there at the bottom of the steering wheel. Would be nice if it was a flat bottom steering wheel just for a little bit of aesthetic, but still think that it's spot on the money. Flat black on the buttons. My question is, did they do anything with the paddles? Because I felt like on the RC models that we've driven on Radies Rides, they're a little bit too far inward. Would like them to come out, but look at the display. I mean, that TFT, the way when you fire it up, you get to see your Lexus IS there. Just the technology really helps create this wonderful feeling. Now, wheel and tire options, you're gonna have no 17-inch wheels. You actually get 18-inch wheel standard, 19-inch wheel is an option, and then a 19-inch wheel BBS, a BBS forged wheel that sheds even more weight at all four corners. Optional triple LED, the triple beam LED headlights, which look really good. Even the stitching there, look at the way they did the red stitching, the AC vent, nice design. I like that aeronautical design. And I'm telling you right now, if I was gonna get one of these, I think F Sport with the circuit red interior is the way to go. Cause when you're able to have that difference between the two colors, it really makes the interior pop. And Lexus materials are just spot on. Look at the stitch work there. The nice brushed aluminum silver, a little bit of flat black, but I'm seeing actually more silver than flat black there. So that's a very, very good sign. I'm glad they didn't put a bunch of gloss black. Usually that's not Lexus, that's not what they do over at Lexus, is a bunch of gloss black. Seats, bolstering looks good, great. It's never been bolstering too aggressive to where you feel like you're getting squeezed like a vice grip, but the leather, from my experience, is always so supple. So wonderful. Ventilated seats, heated seats, and the stitch work is spot on the money. Even the design of the seat, I think they did a phenomenal job there. Center console has those two cup holders without a lid. That could be a possible zonk once I get into it. And I'm not seeing a lot of storage compartments as of right now for any Twinkies or Snickers, but we'll have to see once we get a little bit closer. But obviously, when it comes to quality of materials, that's something that Lexus is known for, and that's why their vehicles hold their value so well. Backseat, you have your armrest there in the center, same, similar design with the seats, and then underneath the hood, you have different options. So if you're gonna go IS350 F-Sport rear-wheel drive, that's a 3.5 liter V6, 311 horsepower, mated to an 8-speed automatic, 0-60, 5.6 seconds. If you're gonna go all-wheel drive, then you're going to be looking at 0-60 around 5.8 seconds. So not a huge difference. IS300 is a 2-liter inline four turbocharged engine, 241 horsepower. That has a 6-speed automatic transmission. The back of this IS, I love. Look at that super clean, well-defined LED lighting out back. That really is going to set it apart from anything else going down the road. New spindle grille. I know it's a love-hate relationship. Some people love the spindle grills. Some people think that Lexus needs to go in a different direction. I think they're spot on the money with the spindle grille. Those wheels are drop-dead sexy. It's like a black chrome finish to them. I absolutely love them. I think we did a LS on here not too long ago, and that thing was phenomenal, the wheels. The F-Sport badge, it'll be interesting to see. Fingers crossed. Please, I'm gonna go get my lucky rabbit's foot. I'm gonna go get a quarter from the Tooth Fairy. I hope they make an ISF. Please, please, please. That would be phenomenal. But look at that body line that comes on the passenger rear door into the, right in front of the rear tire. really nice. I like the way the trim, the brushed aluminum trim in that rear quarter window extends out just enough to make things interesting. Nice flow to the roof. The doors kind of have, that rear doors kind of have a flare out look. And then look at the front. The way they took their signature daytime running lamp and integrated it into the headlight, I'm in love with it. When it was separate, it kind of looked like an afterthought. That looks spot on the money. Look at the way they did the perimeter of the spindle grille, the way it kind of now curves out instead of sharp angles. I just want to rub my hands on it, to be honest with you. And then you have those two lower curtains down there, large mouths with a nice, sort of looks gloss black to me. I can't say for 100% sure, but it looks like it's going to be gloss black, which is okay because that area where that lip spoiler is isn't anything too major. But from the front, the mirror design, everything looks super clean. And I think that's the way I would go. Think about it. The silver with that circuit red interior, there's your daytime running lamps looking so sharp. You can't confuse that car with anything else. But I really think it shows a nice evolution from the previous generation IS 350 and 300, bringing it into here. And it's nice to have all those options. And you can get your IS 300 with all-wheel drive as well. Now, if you go IS 300 with all-wheel drive, you're looking at a 3.5 liter V6 that puts out around 260 horsepower. And with the all-wheel drive systems, if you're wondering, they're rear wheel drive bias. So that means 70% of the power is gonna be going to the rear wheels. It can send up to 50% of the power to the front wheels for a 50-50 perfect distribution. But the front of the vehicle here is just drop dead gorgeous. I mean, I remember with the last gen, when I first saw an IS going down the road, I was like, I did a double take. I think with this car, people are gonna be doing triple takes. I like what they did with the venting. Now, I may have to zonk the vent because that may be fake there. I think there's a side air curtain, but I think some of the other vent might be fake. Fingers crossed that is not the case. We're gonna have to wait until I can actually get these two eyes to get a little bit closer because I can't tell for certain. But let's hope that that's not the case. I do like, if you look to the right there, there was a larger air intake, which did look functional. From the side, you see that body line, how it starts on the lower portion of the front door, curves up, really gives it that nice flared look. And then right behind the taillights, the way they do a nice body line there really shows multi-level definition to the side of the vehicle. Even the way it curves from that rear pillar there, you got one, you got two. It's nice to see that type of styling because it helps give the visual effect of a more flared fender than what it may actually be. But those wheels, just beautiful, stunning wheel. Love the multi-spoke design. That black chrome looks phenomenal. And it's nice to know that you have your different wheel options. You can go standard 18 if you're going IS 300, you can get 19, or with the F-Sport, the dynamic handling package, you can get those BBS wheels, which are gonna save you the weight. And obviously they look really good as well, but all the little designs they really, really did. And I'm so glad that they kept the dual exhaust. One exhaust on each side. I could totally see an ISF exhaust out back there. And that signature lighting with the taillights, I think that's spot on the money. I like the way it goes all the way across. You get a nice trunk lid spoiler there that kind of kicks up. Gives you a nice little visual there as well of that kick up. But I really think that they have a home run on their hands with this IS 350. But if it's things like these you want to keep seeing on Radies Rides, where we do the unveils right here virtually with you, and then once we get our hands on them, we go a little bit deeper, leave a comment in the comment section. If you're new and you're on your way out, hit that subscribe button. I promise you it's worthwhile. Come back for more. If you are a subscriber, thank you for being part of the Radies Rides family. If you want to help us keep making great content just for you on the channel, click the link in the description, get yourself some Radies Rides merch. Gotta give it up to my wonderful wife, Lori, being my production manager, working that camera, getting the lighting. She did such a phenomenal job. Show her some love in the comments. And just like always, guys, I'll see you on the next ride.